I often think about how many cities there are out there under the ocean. Cities where people lived for thousands of years. Cities with their own history, their own culture. All of it lost under the waves. If they'd been less greedy, they could have kept all that.
I don't think we can pass moral judgment on an entire species based on the decisions of a handful of leaders. But I do think they made a mistake. They stopped caring about what they built. They stopped seeing the romance of civilization.
Something I really like about Alex, one of the reasons why I'm here doing this, is that she's really humble. She has this incredibly positive view of humanity. She believes we can accomplish anything, but it's not about her. She doesn't think that she's smarter or better than anyone else. She just looks at us as a species. And even though she can see how small we are in the grand scheme of things, she thinks that we could conquer the stars and give meaning to the universe. Even now. Even when none of us are going to live to see it. Isn't that awesome?
Congratulations! That one looked difficult.
Miranda, would you like to play a game?
A game? That sounds like fun.
It is. Remember what Alexandra Drennan said about games?
They're part of what makes us human.
Exactly. And this is a game Alexandra Drennan designed when she was still in school. It's based on her favorite book. Have a go.
You may wonder why I insist on these unsanctioned, unplanned expeditions. Some think it is because I hate civilization and prefer to lose myself in nature. This is precisely the opposite of the truth. It is because I love New Jerusalem that I have to leave, because it is only when I am here that I fully appreciate what the city means. And also because I believe that if I stayed at home, I would one day be ethically compelled to commit acts of violence against those who, in their arrogance, imagine that humans should live in harmony with the chaos that surrounds us.
paradise cannot be found. It must be built.
Thank you. Courses are broken, not taught. That is the way of humankind.
Friend, and heed my words. Beware Pandora. She is nothing but fear and despair, and she will do anything to prevent you from reaching the flame. It is she who disrupted the trials of the Sphinx, and who bound me in the...
Looks like our hypothesis was correct. The megastructure is opening again. Everyone come to the VTOL, please. It's time to find Athena.
What about Pandora? She seems capable of displacing or controlling the other entities.
We should be careful, but we can't let such a vague threat paralyze us. Just keep your eyes open. There's something I've been thinking about. I know the New Alexandria disaster was traumatic. I know accidents like that make us think that it's best to stick to what we have. But what about all the accidents that have happened in New Jerusalem that nobody talks about? The collapse of the Rakovsky building. The Calvin Street explosion. The derailment that almost killed Benaroya and Kaneda. All of those happened because we stopped investing enough resources in our civilization. And if Melville hadn't been put in charge of city maintenance, this would still be happening.
It will happen again, either way. With how little we have to work with, it's only a matter of time.
You see, there may be a price for pursuing progress, but there's also a price for not pursuing.
Here we go again.
Our main objective is to determine the relationship between the megastructure and Athena. Did she find it? Did she build it? Why was she here in the first place? Explore. Dig up anything you can. We need to start finding answers.
I can't imagine one person building all this.
Don't forget about Miranda. There were at least two of them.
I can't imagine 100 people building this.
All right, everyone. Have a look around, but stay in touch and be careful.
1K, can you stay a moment? I'd like to talk to you. I know you can't wait to start exploring, but just hear me out, okay? I'm concerned. Byron is brilliant, but all he can think about is the possibility of finding Athena. She was his mentor, and her disappearance shattered him. I'm afraid he's not seeing the dangers of the megastructure. To me, this place seems chaotic, dysfunctional. Yes, it's all very impressive, but I think it's broken. And what we're seeing is, it's nonsense, frankly. You've interacted with it more than anyone. What do you think? I don't see it. Or at least I'm not convinced that the pattern is meaningful. Maybe I'm wrong, but please, be careful.